Hi, I'm Lee, and I'm the FP&A Technology Director at Revelwood. This video is going to help you learn more about IBM Planning Analytics. Server Explorer allowed you to manipulate the elements in your subset by doing various searches. You could do wildcard searches, level searches, attribute searches, and thereby take a giant list of elements and filter it down to a smaller subset. The PAW interface allows us to do those same kinds of searches, but it also takes it a step further so that you can make your search criteria much more structured. When I go into my set editor, I have basic search criteria where I can simply search the available members by typing a name. But I can also make it more user-friendly by choosing the option to show search and using drop-down approaches to do my filtering. I can filter by name, I can filter by level, I can filter by attributes. Similar in nature to Server Explorer, but instead of creating three separate buttons, I now have a single approach where I go into a drop-down. Within my name or within my level, I have the ability to determine what do I want to see. I can contain, I can be equal, I can be not equal. I can choose start with and end with. Well, the concept of having contains, the concept of having start with and end with, means that I no longer have the need for an asterisk. I no longer need to do star. If I want to look for all the pieces that start with the letter J, I no longer need to do J star. If I want to look for something that contains the number 123, I no longer have to do star, 123, star. I can select the options contain, start with, end with, and make it more user-friendly and a little bit less technical. How do I use this? Let's just say I want to look at all of the months or all of the base level periods that start with the letter J. I could say name, starts with, all I'm going to do is type the letter J. I'm going to add it to the filter. I've just created a filter. The system won't apply the filter until you tell it to. And the way that you tell the system to apply the filter is simply click on the search button. So as soon as I click on search, it's now going to filter my list and it's going to bring all of the base level periods, or in this particular case, all of the periods that start with the letter J. But the expansion gives me the ability to do multiple filtering. I can do multiple search criteria. So maybe I want to look at all of the periods that start with the letter J, but maybe I also want to look at anything that contains the letter U. I can add this filter. I now have two search criteria. Start with the letter J. Somewhere within it contains the letter U. And when I click on the search button, I now have the ability to only look at the items that meet both criteria. From there, I have the ability to do my movement where I can insert, I can replace, I can move items from the left to the right, manipulate the subset, and search my data. This type of filtering will make it easy for your users to select the data they want to see, thereby giving them a good user experience. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. If you want to learn more, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos like this one, or you can check out our website at revelwood.com.